If you're too much in a haste to get hooked in marriage, Satan will quickly package one of his cousins for you as a suitor. You really don't want to know what it means to have Satan for an in-law. Pay all the price of patience you can pay now. The lost choice is worth waiting for. And this is coming from Pastor Mike Bamiloye. I see him more as an actor, or eventually an actor, but yeah.
Sorry.
What?
He's a pastor?
Yeah.
And an actor.
What's
I'm sorry, I mean, this write-up comes up pretty to me, pretty much unlettered, like someone that's pretty much very unlettered and a clergy.
How, why?
Because, I'm sorry, I mean, do you know the devil? Have you sat with the devil? Do you know
Church
what
the devil is?
The devil's cousin. I mean, who's the devil's cousin? Well, it sounds like something someone unlettered and a cloak paid would just put out there.
Wow.
Who are you trying to impress? What are you, and this is all part of a problem where our society.
Are you saying we don't have devil's cousins?
Who was the devil's cousin?
In the form of man.
And who do you?
I can be packaged and given to all patient women.
I'm just saying. There's a better way he would have gone about putting out what he wants to
he's
say.
He's talking to the masses. This is how masses
no,
talk.
No, he's talking to his flocks.
And I mean, which is a mass.
So he has a bunch of unlettered. Flocks. I mean, he's talking to. I mean, devil's causing this and that. We get your point. You're trying to tell people
to be patient.
Be patient.
Don't rush into marriage.
That's it. Yeah. Go about it more decently and more.
I'm glad that you know he has a point. Or you agree he has
Yeah, but
a
I just
point.
Said the way he went about it, it yeah. sounds like someone who's unlettered.
Sorry,
I mean,
Mavin, it's devil, not for educated elite. It's for
devil's
it's for his people.
You know,
we get it.
So let's dwell on the point.
Yeah.
Which is,
don't be in a rush to get married so that you will not get, how do I put it? That's what it sounds like. So you won't fall into the wrong hands, basically, right? Do you agree?
I don't agree. Okay. Absolutely not.
I think
there's no manual to marriage and love and people. There isn't. We're too complicated for that. I've seen people who wait 100 years. The man is fantastic, 100 years, and you enter the marriage and he changes. Mm-hmm. And I've seen people who have married in less than 6 months and they're still together 24 years. So there is no manual to things. Is there a virtue in patience? Absolutely. In that, because it really depends on what the quality of that time you have spent together looks like. For Nigerians, for example, where your love life looks like, yeah, I'm under my mother's house, you don't see each other at all, you would have the time. I would encourage people to date more because of that. But if you're living together, I feel like, or in like a month, you already know that this man doesn't put the toilet sit down, he doesn't. So from like abroad or whatever, I think people don't need that much time because they're a lot more closer to each other and spend more time with each other. So there is no manual. I saw in the comment section we're just like praying and saying yes, amen. It's not that deep. There is no, that's not a guarantee that you would do okay. Just really open your eyes, ask for wisdom. If that means praying, it's being spiritual, or asking your friends around or people that are in your life that you trust their advice on who this man is and or woman or whoever it is that you're with, and then find out the quality of the person. If you can deal with that for the rest of your life, and you're good to go if that only takes 3 months.
I like how you put it, because it is not about what you did right or what you didn't do right.
Yeah.
Just hope that life doesn't just hit you, because sometimes you do everything right by the books. Mm-hmm. And I like to say there's no rule for these things, right? But we know we've set a certain standard and to say, oh, this is how you should talk to him for the first 1 month or for the first week.
All that is BS.
I mean, the next 3 months, don't do the do, you know, or don't do the do till marriage and blah, blah, blah. And then you do all that and you realize that
it's still a ship basket.
She is.
It's still
all that is, you know, BS.
So,
yeah. You know.
I also understand when people pray about their life partner, because sometimes when it gets overwhelming, you just want to tap into the higher authority and hope that he helps you or guides you, or she, like you always say. But I think we should just be prepared, enjoy the moment, and live each time as it comes. So if tomorrow the most awesome man or woman in your life decides to be the devil's cousin, just be equipped enough to carry on. Stand up and excel. Are you laughing?
Mm-hmm. I'm just saying we're all just a product of collective socialization and social conditioning.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, molds have been created and labels have been given to us, and we're just carrying on and not even questioning stuff.
Mm.
All right, this is somebody who you say is a pastor, and I'm trying to imagine what he says to his flock when he's having his service. You can mislead people with just a statement. All right, like she already said, there's no one mold fit all in marriage. No, it's two people about to start on the journey. It's their experience. They're going to make their mistakes. They're going to find out what doesn't work. But because before we go into it, somebody feels they have the right to call what they call counseling and tell you there's a particular way it should be. And then you go into that stuff. It's not now turning out the way you were counseled. And you begin to feel, oh, wow, it's not working. then the triggers, panic set in, somebody's feeling, okay, this is not what I was told, or I think it's time I exit. I think the whole institution and concept of marriage needs to be deconstructed.
Well,
we need
that whole thing down.
You know, we need to in the light of the 21st century, those modes they created for us.
Are you saying that we shouldn't marry?
No, I'm not saying that.
Okay.
And not everybody's going to get married.
Terms, right?
Yeah.
Mm. Not everybody's going to get married.
Of course.
And not everybody should marry.
Mm-hmm. And everyone needs to marry.
And it doesn't mean there's anything wrong with you.
Okay. Unfortunately, you know, we'll have to go, but I think we'll create more time for you to deconstruct this marriage institution.
Girl.